Today on the Model Workshop, we're going to be taking a look at and building Tamiya's release of the M109A6 Paladin from the Iraq War. This is a cooperation with Italeri and Tamiya using Italeri's older M109A6 kit and some new Tamiya parts and figures. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be inside the box when you get yours. Of course, since it's a Tamiya release, it's going to have their phenomenal manuals, which do give you some written instructions and excellent pictograph details, which lets you know exactly where everything goes. Lots of plastic in this kit. Not as parts intensive as one of the other kits I just built, that Tamaz Typhoon K, but there is a lot of plastic in here that we can look at. You can tell by the different shades what's likely a Tamiya plastic addition, such as the identification panels, fuel tanks, various small details, compared to what would be an Italeri part, which is in a darker plastic. But you can definitely tell this tree is a Tamiya tree because it says it right on it. More identification panels, spare road wheels, pieces of armor, bits and bobs that go on the tank. You can see those figures. Very nice. They are torso and head only. Beautiful stowage. Usually pay quite a bit extra for stowage in 1/35th scale. This one's included in the kit and it's done very, very nicely. Don't have to make your own, and you can see the operator's heads there with their comm units. Very nice looking. We've got the upper hull, vents, turret mount, lower hull where we'll be mounting the torsion bars. You can see inside there. Now those are going to be the old Italeri parts. Let's get out the rest of the plastic. They're on very large trees. We got the monster howitzer barrel in two pieces. More fuel tanks. Hatch parts. 50 caliber. Ammo boxes. Nice accessories there. On this giant tree, we've got the back of the hull, the front of the hull, road wheels, tools, axes, shovels, picks, tanker tools. We've got the hubs for the road wheels. We've got the road wheels themselves, which are one piece. What you'll have to do is paint those a solid black, usually a rubber colored black, and then go over with a circle cutter and spray the hub tan, or you can hand paint it. It's all up to you. Good look at those road wheels. And now the upper hull, where the actual barrel is mounted. Very nice looking. This kit's been around for a while, but it's still a very nice kit. You can pick this new edition up with the additional accessories, Tamiya manual, photo etch, for around $45, so not bad at all. Take a look at all the parts on those trees. Let's switch over what we've got left in the box. We've got some rubber band style tracks, which don't bother me at all. Decals, photo etch, and a neat little bonus item. First, we'll take a look at these tracks. Bottom side with additional links, and top side molded in that nice metallic color this time. A lot of times they're just black vinyl. And we've got extra links. We got a nice set of decals for two units. This is supposed to take place 2003 Iraq. The white decals are, of course, labels for different parts and warnings. Got a nice thing of photo etch for the cargo baskets. Very nice. Not too much photo etch to be, you know, fiddly. Just enough to add that extra enhanced detail. And finally, MRE packages to throw in with your stowage. Nice sheet that usually costs a few bucks from Tamiya all by itself. They include it for you in the package of this kit. So, as usual, everything into the parts washer. I'll start putting stuff together and I'll get back when we've got some sub-assemblies done. See you soon. Update on the progress of the assembly. We're on page 4, step 6. I've got the lower hull assembled. You can see everything on there looks pretty sweet. They have you do all the torsion bars separately, all the shock absorbers separately. We got the drive wheels on there. So we're moving along really well. Everything fits together nice. All the hull pieces go together without any big gaps, any problems, just like I'd expect from something that Tamiya had their hands in. We got the road wheels assembled. Those will be painted completely separate from the model, and then attach at a later point. Same with the tracks. They want you to attach the tracks now. We're going to paint those up and attach those almost one of the last things we're going to do. Next steps after this will be working on the top of the hull and attaching that to the bottom hull, and then adding a bunch of accessories on the top, which we can do. You can still access the complete run of tracks and road wheels with the top of the hull assembled. So I'm going to step into that process now, get that on, attached, and get some accessories on there. When I get done with that, we're going to be assembling the main gun. We'll give you some stops and some looks in between. See you soon again. At this stage, we've got all the heavy-duty assembly done. There are numerous parts left over because what I do in the manual is, as I go, if I'm not going to be assembling a part because I want to paint it and attach it later, on the manuals, I will circle that area and draw an arrow to the side of the page. Then when I go to each page before I finish the model and I look, I can say, okay, you want to attach those tools, you want to attach those ammo cans, you want to attach those fuel and water cans, and etc. So I draw a circle around each one and off to the side. So we're going to have some parts left over that I don't want to attach till I get the main color on the model, get a little work on it, and then I can attach them later. What's left over is all the stowage, of course, spare road wheels, some very small parts. Not all these parts are used on this kit, but it's a large assembly there. We've got a whole bunch of fuel and water containers. What's nice is after you use the photo etch, don't throw it away because these small parts right there are actual buckles for the water cans that'll be stowed on board. So we've got stuff like that. We've got small tools that will get painted separately and then attached. Some tools were attached to the hull, stuff that they probably would have sprayed over when they were sending them overseas, but other stuff they would have left and had them separately because they would have been pulled off and used, but you can see some small stuff left over. We got the identification panels on. The lower hull went together just fine. We got the, I was never on a howitzer, so I forget exactly what that's called, but it's the stowage support there for the main barrel. And as long as you glue it carefully, it will open and close and lift forward and back. We've got the extra track links on the hull. I'll paint over those and just shadow them a little bit. Identification panels, suspension. The whole hull went together very nice. Now in the back, it does have the spades, but they have you assemble them up. If you wanted to, you could have them down and assemble it in a firing position. That would be very easy to do, and you can make that decision. But mine will be as if it's in transport with the barrel all the way down, locked into the holder there. The hatches can open and close. You can either glue them closed or open. The upper hull, the turret, goes together just fine. I left those tools on there. I glued those on. Those will be painted over. The photo etch for the baskets, you can see it on the back. Now the baskets can be turned in and locked into that little clip there where my thumb is as stowed, or they can be deployed. Now I want them deployed because I want to cover the whole thing with stowage and everything. On the top here is where the tow cable is. That's where those holes are for, but I want to be able to spray it with some good amount of paint. I glued the hatch open because I want to use the figure. If you're going to use the figure, they have you glue his little stand in there. There is no interior. There's no 50 cal on here because I want to paint that separately and attach it after I've painted. The barrel will rise up and down as long as you don't glue everything in place. If you follow the directions, the barrel will rise up and down. As you can see, the seam on that is not a big deal at all. Once that dries, a little scuff with 120 grit sandpaper, that'll pretty much disappear completely. No filler needed. We've got everything glued on there, all the tiny little handles. Everything went together fine. And the turret attaches to the hull very easily. Turns around, moves around, and comes detached as you need for painting or possibly transporting to a model show or whatnot. So I'm going to start doing some painting. I'm going to give the hull and turret a coat of desert tan. The road wheels will be black and tan. The stowage will be a mixture of different uniform colors, different fabric colors. I'll be doing both figures because I think they're really nice looking figures. So I'll be doing all those up. As I go and paint along, we'll be back for updates. We'll see you soon. I've got the base coat of desert tan on the hull. You can see I put the turret onto the hull. Now the turret can be rotated left and right. The gun can be elevated and lowered. And you can remove the turret as well for more painting and weathering if you want. It just simply slots in there. You saw the slots when I was showing you the sub-assemblies. But I just wanted to see how it's going to look when I put it together. I'm going to put it with the barrel down and stowed and locked in place so they can travel. So what we have to do next is I've primered the stowage for a little bit of shadows underneath, and I'll hand paint those. I've primered the road wheels, and I've got to paint out the centers, which I'll use a circle guide for, you know, a regular circle cutter. And then finally, I'll attach all the stowage to the tank and start doing some light weathering. But before we get that far, I'm going to get all the stowage painted, the road wheels painted. I'm going to be painting the tracks. From everything I looked up online, the tracks, when they come off the line and they're just first shipped to the country and they're ready to go, of course, they're not all rusted and beat up yet. They're mostly just a body color, the desert tan, on the metal link on the outside, and then the rubber pads, of course, have worn down so that there's no paint on them. So I'm going to do them roughly like that. The tank's going to be weathered a little bit, but not extremely heavy. Let me get the painting, the stowage, the tracks, the road wheels, get it all assembled. We'll come back before I start weathering, and I'll see you soon. The Paladin is assembled, and the first wash has been applied. Now, this was what I call a spray wash, and it's not detergent. It is, I take black paint, I mix it with windshield washer fluid till it's down to the consistency of the windshield washer fluid. So in other words, it's like black food coloring almost. I take my airbrush at the highest PSI and I soak the whole thing so it's covered with a layer of black. That quickly starts to run off. And what's left is all these really nice accents all over the vehicle. Now, the grates here, of course, I applied it much heavier so it would stick in there. But the rest of the vehicle is just done with that spray. On a tan finish like this, it really sticks in to all the nooks and crannies, and I don't have to keep going in with such fine tools with a thicker wash and trying to remove it. All I have to do is let this sit for about an hour, and it's going to dry up, and it's going to look pretty darn amazing all on its own. It's going to look dusty. It's going to look dirty. You can see I've got the tracks assembled. Now, if you go online and watch these things, the tracks are drooped at the top, but they are not drooped to the point that they are sloppy like they would be on a Tiger tank, where when the tank is in gear, the track is still hanging quite low because it's so heavy. When these tanks are howitzers, or the tank howitzer, it's a howitzer, when it's moving, you'll see tension on this track at all times. Even when it's sitting still, when it comes off the drive wheel here and comes down, it doesn't immediately loop down and touch that first road wheel. Unless they put it in reverse, then it kind of collapses on itself and it goes backwards. But so I rung it up, glued it to the top of the road wheels so that it's got that nice droop into it, but it's not as serious of a droop as you'd expect on other tanks. So we're going to continue letting that top layer dry. While that's going on, the stowage out here, I've got painted the main colors with a first black wash. Then I'm going to dry brush in the main color and a couple other colors like browns and stuff, just to bring out some detail on those. I've got to glue up some ration boxes and place those before I'm all done with the machine. We'll do the figures dead last. I've got them assembled. I want to put them dead last so that I can put them right on the howitzer, right on the Paladin, and be all done with it. I've got to place all the different fuel cans around in the stowage baskets and whatnot. I've got the ones that are bolted to the hull already in place and they look nice. I'm just going to go in with a very fine brush now that the wash is done and paint the straps across there a little bit just to bring them out. Same on the other side. I've got the gas cans, the fuel cans, the water cans on there. I'm just going to paint the straps just a little bit different color just to bring those out so they don't look like they're hovering in space. But all the tools are attached, the road wheels. I put extra track links on the front. I've got all the ammo boxes. I've got to attach the 50 caliber on top. But all the tools are on there, the tools that would have been painted separately. You can see they're glued on, then I washed. Now their mounting points are a different color. I'm going to paint those the same chassis color just before I finish, same as the straps on there. Got the decals on, very few decals to put on this vehicle. Got those on there. Got the identification marks. We got the back end washed out. Can't see much of the back end at all. The baskets are all washed out. It's looking really, really nice. And we're just about done. I'm having a lot of fun with it. So I'm going to continue working on that stowage down here. get that mounted, get it in the baskets, get it set on top, paint the antennas, do the very fine detail painting. Then I'm going to paint the figures. When I come back, folks, the Paladin will be completely done. See you soon. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the completed U.S. self-propelled howitzer M109 A6 Paladin, dated about 2003 from Tamiya, and a cooperation with Atalari. Atalari, it doesn't matter how you say it, because the kit comes out awesome no matter how you say it. This was built 100% from the box. I did not add any accessories. I did not add any photo etch. I did not add any stowage or any munitions boxes. Those were all included in the kit. I really like this one. It turned out real well. I weathered this one more than I normally weather a military kit because these were out in the desert. These were actually used in combat, so they did get a little beat up and a little weathered. I did some chip effects with a number 2 pencil, dragging it along the edge. You can see, like, along the headlights right there, around the commander's cupola there, his hatch, stuff like that, on the edges of the tools, on the edges of the cargo boxes. It's just real nice kit. I really enjoy it. Use the factory decals. Got some more chipping around the rear fenders. You can see those washes and weathering came out real nice. Not too much. Not so much that it looked like it was a used up piece of junk, but that it looked like it was actually used. We got the nice MRE boxes on top. We got the stowage. Painted the stowage, the water, fuel, grease cans, all different colors so that it would signify different materials used. When they were sent in Iraq, some of their packs were still green, some were tan, some were desert camo. So it's a whole nice mix, and it makes for a beautiful, beautiful kit. When I was done, I did some light dust effects on the tracks and on the sides of the vehicle with a very little bit on top. It just absolutely looks stunning. Did a little bit of what I would call heat weathering to the barrel, where the smoke from the exhaust, when it's fired and it blows the smoke out the barrel, it's going to have a little bit of a staining effect. Just an all-around wonderful kit. No issues building it, and it turned out beautifully. There'll be a link in the description where you can get yours. Once again, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.